I'm gonna make an authoritative post on the topic of organized stalking in a targeted individual's career, since I'm an expert on this subject. I'm out of a job again, but this time it's because of medical issues, and the agency isn't going to fight my claim, or so they say. And I'd sent them an email explaining what happened, along with a few scans of the related Walgreens prescriptions, doctor note, etc. And one thing I will say is the agency had no problem whatsoever answering my email and even provided a link to the unemployment website. Unlike the rich man who tried to gloat a couple months ago and wouldn't even give me a letter so I could get food stamps. That's a must-read story. Put some links. So anyway, this agency I was working for is run by decent people. It's too bad the job didn't work out. The agency probably had a bonus at stake contingent on me being hired after contract completion. At least they made money while I worked. And I just wanted to make that clear first. Now, I've had some problems in the past with job references, not because of my performance, but because some people, for some reason, were telling lies about me to prospective employers. I was being blackballed. I know that because over the years, a couple of people have informed me that there was a problem with some of my references and what the problem was. It's illegal in Illinois to give out personal information about a former employee to a prospective employer or credit card check, etc. The law in Illinois is very specific about what information former employers are allowed to disclose. The penalty includes possible prison time, but proving a former employer is blackballing a person is not easy. Blackballers are most often too smart to provide lies in writing. They do it on the phone where they leave no evidence, and it's extremely rare when a prospective employer will tell a person about such illegal action by former employers. It's even more rare for a prospective employer to try and obtain the proof in writing. Now, I've never been able to get anyone to do that for me. The most they've ever done is tell me about some of the bullshit that's been said. And this was an issue 15 years ago. Today, this problem is worse and still growing in America as the number of targeted individuals increases and the number of people willing to commit the stalkings for profit or fun increases. So I falsified my resume 3 times over the past 15 years to counter some blackballers. That makes it hard to get a job at any company that does a thorough background check. Luckily, I usually become one of the top programmers or setup men at most places I work at, so I've been able to overcome the occasional blackballer without too much trouble. I just have to work at shitty companies. If the company believes in the right tool to do the job, then I'm one of the best. You need the right tool and a proper sequence of machining operations. That's a bigger issue than most non-machinists would believe. So because of my expertise in this area, I intend to inform people about the issue of organized stalking and the targeting of individuals' careers. It's going to be a series of posts. Now, I'm also going to restore my resume after posting about a couple of places I removed from my resume. I have another story from a few years ago that's migraine related, but that owner was not a decent person at all, unlike the company agency that I just finished working at. So, after I restore my resume, I'm going fishing for assholes as I job hunt this time. I bet they won't be able to resist telling lies over the phone. The question is, will anyone do anything about it when it appears?